In this video, we'll show you how to create a chained mapping. Besides, we'll show you how to map only books that contain a specific string and how to use the if-else condition. Finally, we will explain how to create a text file directly in the mapping and sort its data in ascending order. Our source component is a JSON file with a schema definition. Let's add our source component to the mapping. Our first target component is an XSD schema called booklist. Now let's add our schema to the mapping. First of all, let's connect the object with the book element. Let's continue connecting all the other nodes. Now let's check the output. Now our task is to filter the JSON data and map only those books that contain the string Harry. For this purpose, we will set a filter on the connection between the object and the book element. For the Boolean parameter, we will supply the result of the contains function. Double-click the mapping area. Start typing contains. And then double-click the function. Let's connect the book node with the value parameter. For the substring parameter, we will add a constant. And then we will type Harry in the text bar. Now we need to connect the constant with the second parameter of the function. Finally, we need to connect the result of the function with the Boolean parameter of the filter. If the title of a book contains the string Harry, this book item will be mapped to the target file. Let's check the output. We can see that all the book titles contain the search string. Our next goal is to supply additional information about books if their prices exceed $10. For this purpose, we will need the if-else condition, the greater function, and a couple of constants. First of all, let's add the if-else condition to the mapping. The Boolean parameter will accept the result of the greater function. Let's connect the price node with the first parameter of the greater function. For the second parameter, we will add a constant. Let's type 10 and select the number option. Let's connect the constant with the second parameter of the function. Then we need to connect the result of the function with the Boolean parameter of the if-else condition. We also need another constant to supply its value to the value true parameter. We will type the following text. Now let's connect this constant with the value true parameter. The last step is to connect the result of the if-else condition with the info element. The greater function will compare the price value of each book with the value of the constant. If the price is greater than $10, the string to expensive will be mapped to the info element. Let's see the output. Now some of our books have this new information. Our second target is a text file with comma-separated values. We don't have this file yet, but we will create it directly in the mapping. First of all, let's insert a text component. MapForce will suggest the following options. You can use the FlexText utility to work with complex structures, or you can use a simple standard file. We will select the simple option. Our component will be called booklist. Next, we will type the path of the output file. Now we need to add fields that will become mappable nodes in the component. Our first field is called book. And it's a string. Let's add another field. This field will be called author, which is also a string. Let's continue adding other fields. The last step is to select the option First Row Contains Field Names. This will make it much easier to understand the correspondence between the nodes and their values. Now the second target is available in the mapping area. Let's connect the book element with the rows node. As soon as we connect the first and second targets, a new button appears in the booklist component. This button allows you to pass the output of the first target to the next target. Let's see the output. Besides being able to see the second output, we can also switch between the output files. Our last goal is to sort the book data of the second target in ascending order. Let's set the sort component on the connection between the book and rows nodes. Right-click the connection. Then select Insert Sort in the context menu. We want to sort our data by title. Let's also check this button over here. This button means our data will be sorted in ascending order. You can also choose to sort your data in descending order. Let's check the output. Now we can see that all the book items are in ascending order. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altova website.